Hello everyone. It's us again. Who are we?
Jinx.
Jinx. It's John and the J Girls, and we are the host of this broadcast called RWHA Culture. And once again, we are here with another interesting topic, one of our house rules, and we look forward to having a very good chat with you. One of the most difficult ones for me. I hope you catch up very soon. Thank you. We are back. Yes, I said it's one of the most difficult house rules for me to achieve. But before I go into the most difficult house rule for me to achieve, I'd like the girls to remind us, what are the house rules we've been doing? We have we have honesty and
respect.
Responsibility.
And we have to walk away.
Walk away. And words and responsibility. So we've just respect. Good. We've mentioned all the house rules we've been doing. And interestingly, it has been a journey telling the whole world this is our house rules and hugs. Yeah. It has been a very big journey telling the whole world. And for us, there are times of tears, joy, and trying to understand why this house rule is there. We should not just do anything with it. But today, like I said, the house rule that I find most difficult is...
forgiveness.
Forgiveness. Wow. Last week, I think I gave a little bit of a hint about my life when I said it was a very difficult thing to learn to walk away because I was very sticky with situation, and I stick with situation, and sometimes the situation hurts me, and rather than releasing, I end up keeping it inside my heart and, you know, harbor all the pain inside. And so that led to many years of unforgiveness. But with the help of my superhero, I've learned to walk the journey of forgiveness. I'm not perfect yet, but forgiveness is one of the things that I will learn to do. And girls, can you remind me how did I write forgiveness on our vision board?
We wrote forgiveness in the middle.
Uh-huh.
And then you wrote three other words around.
What is it?
I think she should say it.
What are they?
Forgive yourself.
Uh-huh.
Forgive others.
Uh-huh.
And forgive all.
Forgive God. And I think one of the questions Binky always had is, why do we have to forgive God? And a very sweet reminder is, a lot of times we blame God for all the things that have happened to us. We are all humans and we are all flawed and we all have our own selfishness. But when our selfishness and all our gains end up in a very terrible situation, we turn on to God and say, God, why did you allow this to do this? I hate you. I curse you. And so you have all those pent-up moments where you vex to God and you say, I cannot forgive you, you don't exist.
Like, but you count down, mm-hmm. you count down curses on him.
You count down curses on him. But the truth is, it did not allow the situation to happen, right? And so another very difficult one is forgiving yourself. Woo! That is a very difficult one because you need to release yourself to move forward. And a few years ago, when I went through a very terrible time, one of the difficult things to do was to forgive myself. Why? Because the basic thing I started asking myself, why did I ever get into that situation? And I had to learn to forgive myself for getting into that situation, which was very hard. And the third one is forgiving others. And I always tell people, forgiving others is the easiest of all. Once you've been able to forgive yourself and forgive God, it's easy to forgive others because you've already released yourself from the yoke or the burden you've placed on yourself. So it's easy to release others. You know, we said sometimes that we need to learn to respect ourselves, take responsibility first. Wait, you're in a classroom.
I know. But before you start saying that, you like release yourself from the burden of unforgiveness.
You release yourself from the burden of unforgiveness. But you know, when we're talking about respect, we said respect comes from you. So all these house rules start from you. So forgiveness also starts from you. If you learn this act of forgiving ourselves, it will be easy for us to forgive others and forgive God. And so we had some slides we want to show today that talks about forgiveness, and we'll just discuss it. We got all this from the internet. We don't owe anything. And I think it's only my own chat slide on my vision that belongs to me. But all these are free. I saw them on the internet. So we'll just read this, what the definition of forgiveness means here, which is a summary of everything we've been saying. Forgiveness is forgetting the hurt,
offering a new beginning, restoring a friendship,
giving and receive,
identifying responsibility, valuing the truth,
ending an argument,
not holding a grudge, encouraging honesty,
saying sorry,
and starting again.
Oh my goodness, I don't have to go into all that. That everything about forgiveness, and it's beautiful to realize that we can accomplish valuable relationships by going through that, but it's quite difficult sometimes. Can we be honest?
Mm-hmm.
Why is it difficult?
Because sometimes maybe they've done something bad, or like maybe it's not even that bad, but even if it's hurt your feelings a little or a lot, sometimes you don't want to repeat it, then you want to leave that hole where it's been damaged, because sometimes it just feels nice to hold it down. But it isn't nice in the long term. So that's why it's hard.
Okay, what about you?
It's quite hard starting again.
It's quite hard starting again. That's true.
And it's quite hard ending an argument.
Oh, God, tell me about it. Hey, this is Jake. Oh my goodness, oh my house is interesting. Yeah, very true. It's quite hard to end an argument. But forgiveness means ending an argument from today, right? Thank you so much. And forgiveness means encouraging honesty. Yeah, saying sorry. One of us here doesn't like saying sorry. I won't mention you. I didn't mention any name. You just gave it away yourself. So that is what the forgiveness is. And so, Little J?
Forgiveness heals the cracks in our
hearts. Yeah.
Sorry.
It does. It heals the cracks. It heals the grudge. It heals the hole that the other person or we have created for ourselves. When we forgive ourselves, that begins the process of healing. And the person who forgives is always forced to be blessed. Right? Let's keep that in mind. When you take the first step to forgive, more blessing is coming towards you. Right? Any comment about that?
No.
Self-explanatory. So it says forgiveness isn't the absence of anger. I think it's also the presence of self-love, self-forgiveness. When you actually begin to value yourself. Does that make sense? How does that make sense to you?
It's not just saying that when you forgive, it takes away the anger, but also adds value. It takes away something bad and has to be good.
It takes away something bad. Okay, what do you want to say?
It's when you forgive somebody, you love yourself more and you love yourself more and you love yourself more till you love yourself.
Okay, good. So when you forgive, you take away the anger, then you begin to love yourself more because you are stronger. You know, we said in the first life, we said you are the first to be blessed. Then the cracks in your heart begins to heal. And then you begin to create the self-love, the self-awareness of who you are.
Cracks heal, blessings come, and you love
you value yourself. Interesting. So, Big J, what's the other one?
Forgiveness doesn't excuse their behavior. Forgiveness prevents their behavior from destroying their heart.
Good. So, because we said your heart is cracked, it's like a flower vase that is cracked. What forgiveness does to the flower vase is it stops it from completely being destroyed.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
it mends it.
So forgiveness mends it, and it does not shatter your heart. So let's assume somebody has hurt you, your best friend hurts you. You understand? So what you do is, when you forgive your best friend, it does not excuse the behavior of your best friend. It doesn't make it all right.
It doesn't make it all right. There's a word, I don't know what the word is.
Yeah.
It might continue with
it. Yeah. It doesn't make it all right what she has done. But what it does is it stops her actions from hurting you more because you choose to forgive. There's something called forgiveness in advance, right? So you have that bowl of forgiveness in advance. Okay, that whenever, I won't mention it, whenever so-so-so hurts me, I'm going to make sure I have that in advance to give to her.
Oh, yeah. Before you said that, it's like lava coming in to, like, where exactly is this going? Lava going into the world.
So when a volcano happens, the lava is coming out. What happens?
And then there's something that like stops it from.
What stops the volcano? What stops the lava? It solidifies, right? Forgiveness solidifies. Well, very interesting concept.
It dries
it up. So let's say unforgiveness is the lava that is coming out of the volcano of anger, bitterness. Yeah? And so when it's blowing up.
It dries.
Yeah,
like
forgiveness.
Obsidian.
Yeah, forgiveness just dries it up. Right?
Doesn't always turn into obsidian, Dad. Sometimes it turns into another type of rock or salt.
Ah.
And granite.
Now we are having some geologists here. Well done, girls. And so that's what forgiveness does. It breaks up and solidifies the anger, and it doesn't destroy. Doesn't destroy your heart, but it doesn't excuse the person from what they've done. Now we are coming from where we are coming. This is a very important part of Islam to us, and as Christians, we cannot but express one of the important concepts to me as forgiveness. He said, to be a Christian, you can put Muslim there, you can put Buddhist there. But at the moment, I am talking because I'm a Christian. To be a Christian means to forgive the inexcusable, because God has forgiven the
inexcusable in you. You.
I mean, so that means if I can't forgive others, how do I expect him to forgive me?
Yeah.
You don't expect him. So the rule of thumb is, before you can go to God as a Christian, you say, God, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me. Have you forgiven others? So that is very, because he has forgiven me all my inexcusable, all my excuse. So God has forgiven you all your inexcusable things. So it's time for you to forgive others. And the other one we have there is, we can read that.
Whoever would foster love covers over an offense, but whoever repeats the matter separates close friends.
Ooh. So whoever wants to create an environment of love would always overlook an offense, forgive an offense. But if you really want close friends to be separated, hold a grudge.
Mm-hmm.
Beat the mouth, telling, do you know she said that about you? Do you know she said that about you? What happens? Friendships start breaking because we tell tales and we hold grudges against others. Right?
Yeah.
Tell us. So, Little Jay.
Forgiveness doesn't change the past, but it enlarges the future.
Exactly. What do you think is saying there?
It's saying that it doesn't make the past that already happened, it doesn't make it better, but it makes the future better.
Beautiful. Give me five.
doesn't cancel what has happened before, but it makes your future easier.
Exactly. So forgiveness does not take the past away. Let me say something. All the things that have happened to me in the past, the abuses I went through, the people that cheated on me, the uncomfortable relationships, my bosses and all the things they've done to me, academic and all the things they've done to me, it doesn't make my past go away. But what forgiveness done for me is to enlarge my future, because I see a brighter future. I see a brighter day. That is what forgiveness does. Forgiveness gives you a future. It gives it's like you are living in a prison. When forgiveness comes, what happens?
It breaks
the chains and it opens the door. You know, when you open the door, you see the sun. I can see
the rain.
I
can see clearly that.
Yeah, So that's what forgiveness does. So the rain just goes. The rain of unforgiveness goes. And then you see the sun. That's what forgiveness does. Mm-hmm. And so the other one says, anger makes you smaller. Why? Forgiveness forces you to grow beyond where you are. Do you believe that? Mm-hmm. When you keep getting angry and you keep holding on to grudge, what happens? You are smaller and smaller. You know, when you're in a prison, you know, first of all, when you sit down in the prison, you are stretched. Then the more pain, you begin to scratch in your prison. So it makes you smaller and smaller and smaller. But what does forgiveness do? It breaks you free. You are bigger. So unforgiveness is a prison. You know that unforgiveness leads to a lot of diseases, because you crouch and you crouch and you lose yourself and you lose your mind. And before you know it, you become sick. Depression, cancer, all kinds of sicknesses can be as a result of forgiveness, unforgiveness. So we have to watch it. Okay, guys, let's continue. Big J.
I think the first step is to understand that forgiveness does not exonerate the perpetrator. Mm-hmm. Forgiveness liberates the victim. Mm-hmm. It's a gift you give yourself.
So what does that mean?
It means forgiveness does not make the person who you're forgiving, it doesn't make them right.
Mm-hmm. Good.
But it allows you to be set.
Perfect. That's exactly what it means. It means that it doesn't clear the person that has wronged you. It doesn't clear the person that have done something. But what it does is it frees you. It frees you as a victim. And that is a gift. The best gift you can give to yourself in life is to forgive. It's hard sometimes. Let's assume they kill my child now. Or anybody kills my child. But you know, the best gift I can give myself is to forgive whoever that I've done wrong to. Really, TJ, can you read the next one?
To forgive is to set a prisoner free and discover that the prisoner is you.
Exactly! That just comes back to what we just read before. It makes sense, because you are the prisoner. When you don't forgive, you are the prisoner. But when you forgive, you set yourself free from the prison you have created by yourself, because you are the prisoner that locked yourself up in unforgiveness. So whenever we don't forgive, we have locked ourselves up in a prison and we are there. Except once we forgive, we unlock the prison we locked ourselves and we are free. That is a very important quote. A very, very important quote. To err is human. To forgive is divine. In
what
other words,
erring?
To do something wrong. To do something wrong is human. All of us who keep doing something wrong. But to forgive is
divine.
It's divine to forgive. It's extraordinary. It's not everybody that can forgive. Everybody can do wrong. We all do wrong, but it's not everybody that can forgive what has been wrong or who has been wrong. Is that true? Yes. And the other one said, the weak can never forgive. Forgiveness is an attribute of a
strong.
It takes a strong person. So I can say for me that I'm forgiving. Oh, how many strong? What am I feeling like? Anyway, so it takes a strong person to forgive. I'm still learning. Maybe if you hurt me today, I won't forgive easily. But it takes a very strong person to learn or to forgive. Litsuye, can you read that?
I believe forgiveness is the best form of love and ending a relationship. It takes a strong person to say they're sorry and even stronger.
Ow. Listen.
Be quiet. Forgiveness is the best form of love. Actually, today we wanted to do another house rule, which is love. But we had a bit of a discussion, and I told the girls, without love, you can't forgive. And so that's the ultimate. I didn't know I was going to get this quote. And this quote is just perfect what I was telling them today, because it takes a strong person to say, I'm sorry. It takes a strong person to say, I'm sorry. So little Jay, yeah.
Strong.
And it takes a stronger person to say, I forgive. Yeah, so
BJ, you are stronger.
Anyway, so the next one says, there is no love without forgiveness, and there is no forgiveness without love.
Yeah, that's what you're saying.
That's it. And then you can't take both of them away. You can't forgive someone without love.
You can't separate them. They're like the other thing.
Exactly. Whatever they are, give me five. So both of them work together. You can't say, I forgive you without loving. And you can't say, I love you without. Is that important? So as we go forward and as we grow up, we'll get difficult people, difficult situations. There's always remember that love and forgiveness. Forgiveness is not a feeling. It's a commitment. It's a choice to show mercy, not to hold the offense up against the offender. Forgiveness is an expression of love.
So you do, when the person offends you, you do abandon them back to forgive.
You make a choice. You make a choice. You make a commitment. I choose to forgive you. Peter, there are times that you do something for me. What do I say? I say, I forgive you.
Yeah.
Because I had to actually say it out, you know. And the truth is, in the family, that's when we get ourselves, when we get offended with each other most. And it takes a commitment, a choice to say, I show you mercy, I forgive you. And because I forgive you, I'm expressing my love to you. That's what I'm just doing. So every time I say, Big J, I forgive you, I'm just saying, I love you. So do you understand now? So next time I say, I forgive you, I'm just telling you, I love you.
When I say I love you.
Big J, can you read that one?
Forgiveness allows us to let go of pain in the memory. And if we let go of the pain in the memory, we can have the memory, but it does not control us. The memory controls us, and we're pockets of the past.
Ooh. Let's break this down. What's it saying there?
You can still have the memory of a bad thing that happened, but when you forgive, it takes away the pain.
Good!
But it doesn't take away the whole thing.
Good! Good! So forgiveness takes away the pain, but it doesn't take away the memory. If you want me to tell you everything people have done for me, I can tell you pain point, but it does not come with the pain anymore. A lot of it doesn't come with the pain anymore. I'm not holding the pain, but I have the memory, because it doesn't take away. You are still human. You remember what they did to you 10 years. You remember what I did to you 20 years from now.
Oh, I thought you said 20 years ago. It's like
20 years from now, you remember what I've done for you. But because you've forgiven me, you might not feel the pain, but you will remember, wow, my mom was strict.
Or is.
Yes. Because I'll still be around them. Yeah. So, but you will remember those memories, but you don't remember the pain that came with it, because you are forgiven. But if you keep holding on to the pain, you are the puppet of the past. That means you have not yet forgiven. That's what he's saying. So interesting quotes. I like those quotes. And oh, look at that picture. What's that picture saying?
The ball that they the pain.
Uh huh.
Guy,
uh-huh,
it's running in the scissors, it's forgiveness. it's not forgiveness, but it's what forgiveness does.
What forgiveness does. So forgiveness cuts you away from the yoke, the pain, the prison, any other terrible word we can use for unforgiveness, and it sets you free. I had to forgive a person who wasn't even sorry.
Ooh.
That's strength.
Ooh.
Tell me about it, sister. I had to forgive someone who wasn't saying sorry, and it took everything in me to forgive. I cried day and night, but I had to. And even when I was saying, oh, you hurt me badly, the person was still actually fighting and upsetting me more. Ooh. Yep. Yeah. You want to know who that person is? Can I say? No. All right. So, yeah, it's grandpa. Grandpa hurt me so much. My grandpa, my dad, grandpa. Grandpa hurt me so much that when I went to meet him to say, I forgive you for hurting me, he abused me again.
What?
Yes. So, but that's what it is. Forgiveness makes you go and say sorry for the person who is not able to say sorry. You still forgive them. And my very good friend, my hero, Jesus of Nazareth, said, read that liturgy.
For if you forgive other people and they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you.
Yes.
Yes.
So for if you forgive other people when they sin against you, your heavenly Father was to forgive him. You know the reason why I brought grandpa's story was as a child, I'm not sure I was 100% perfect, and I don't think any child is 100% perfect. And so for me to hold a grudge against my dad doesn't make me, for one of us here, our love language is words. Hey, and then every time you hear those bad words coming at you, what happens? Why should you say that? Just be boxing yourself inside. But you have to learn. As the words are coming, just repel it. I forgive. It's a lifelong journey. I'm in my 40s right now, and I'm still on the journey of forgiveness. Because the next time somebody hurts me, I have to make a commitment, like we said before in our last life. A commitment, a choice. I have to make a commitment to show mercy to an offender. I have to. So that's why everything we do is a commitment. You know, before we came on earth, we spoke about something about commitment today. Yeah. Everything we do is about commitment. Every single thing, we make a decision in every single thing we do. So to cut the long story short, today we have to go. Anyone needing a forgiveness today? So as we are speaking, friends, boys and girls, families, uncles and aunties, daddies and mommies, grandpas and grandma, everybody out there, does anybody need your forgiveness? Does everybody need your forgiveness? Does anybody need your forgiveness today? Oh my goodness, I love this show. Please, does anybody need your forgiveness today? Please, I want you to take some time. We are pleading with you. Forgiveness releases you, first of all, the prisoner, because you put yourself in the prison of unforgiveness. And once you're able to forgive yourself, you can forgive others and even forgive God.
Like, forgiveness is like the key.
It's the key.
It's
the key to life. Forgiveness releases you from the prison.
Fulfilling life.
Because you need that key constantly. And kids, don't throw away your key of forgiveness. Hold it. Don't let anybody take it away. Because once somebody offends you and you are locking yourself in that prison, you can just take the key and say, now off I go. So we want to say thank you for joining us on RWJ Culture today.
Our topic today is forgiveness, and I hope you join us next time on another interesting house room topic chat, which is I don't know. See you next time.